Hey, what's going on, guys? In this video, I want to talk about the new generation shooter. And this is just kind of a fun talk out loud video. This is just an experience I had just the other night at the range talking to two different new generation shooters, meaning one was 29 years old, and the other guy was 25 years old. And just the way they thought, you know, just the way they behaved, it's interesting how things have changed. So before I go on, just quickly, I am being shadow banned at the moment. Anytime I do a video about a gun that looks like that, AR-15, or any type of quote-unquote long gun, it looks evil and looks like it belongs on a soldier or something, those type of videos get scrutinized, as well as range videos. So I'm not sure what's going on here. I had a range time short on this. Would not pass go. I don't know if it was because the magazine looked like this. Maybe they'll know what this is. I mean, I don't know. So I got to figure that out. So shadow ban, meaning the algorithm suppresses the video. It doesn't show up in feeds and people don't get notifications. Some people do. Okay. Overwhelming majority will not. It's kind of interesting. All right, let's not talk about that. Let's kind of continue on with this video. So this will be a kind of a short one, I guess. We'll see if it's short. So basically the other night I was at the range shooting this fine firearm right there. I was having a lot of fun. This gun right here, I think I might turn this into a primary defensive tool over my Mark 18 upper. I don't know. I'm not sure yet. But for the most part, this is just to reminisce the early 2000s, like I told these two individuals at the range. While I was shooting this, two new gen shooters came up to me because they were curious about this gun. They were looking at it, they were questioning it, they were kind of like, what is it, you know? So let me just take this camera off the tripod and we'll continue this. So they were kind of interested in this fixed rear sight right here. And that front sight post, the 25-year-old was just like, I've never seen an AR that looked like that. Why is there this front sight post? Isn't that the old way? They don't make those anymore. I'm like, are you kidding me? I know this guy, the 25-year-old, just, I guess, started shooting like this year. So I guess I should cut him some slack. But he was like, that thing looks so old. I mean, it's almost like the 1911 here. They think it's like antiquated. I mean, they didn't say this was antiquated, but it's kind of what they're insinuating, I guess. The 29-year-old guy had an SBR with an 11.5-inch barrel. That was a really nice AR that he had. But anyways, he was also questioning this setup, saying, well, what is that red dot you got there? Why is it so big? And then he was so intrigued by the light and shocked that this was a surefire. And he's like, what is that thing? Why is it so big? And I said, this is a very old, you know, type of weapons light. And he's like, god damn. I said, why don't you get yourself a scout light? And I'm like, well, you know, I actually do have one that's actually on my actually defensive 5.56 upper, if you want to call it that, right here. So this is actually a surefire scout light. But this one here is actually a surefire, and he was shocked to see that. And he's like, I've never seen a surefire look like that. Well, I guess this is from back in the day. And it spits out a whopping 125 lumens. Doesn't even have an LED bulb. I actually have a replacement LED lamp that can go in here. I could probably make it basically like a scout light. But that's what they're used to, an LED that's pretty bright versus a old school 125 lumens. I think I have the other lamp that can up this to 225, maybe another 100 lumens. And like I said, I have an aftermarket LED lamp that can go in here that can just basically make it like a scout light. So they were just very interested in this light. They're just curious, like, that's weird that you would, I think the 25-year-old was like, that's weird that you would put old technology on a gun like this. And I'm like, well, again, I wanted to put this together more so for me to remember the early 2000s, because this is something that I was shooting, looked like this kind of back then. They're like, what is that, an aim point what pro? I'm like, yeah, oh, that cheap one. Oh, you gotta get yourself a you know, the real one. So I'm like, I mean, like a T2. So that guy had a comp M5 on his AR, SBR. And Yeah, I didn't say that I had one, but I was like, whatever. The Aimpoint Pro is not a cheap, you know, it's an affordable red dot, but I wouldn't call it cheap, okay? I don't know, to each their own. So let me put this back on the tripod, hold on. So after, you know, a couple minutes of them kind of not really like putting the gun down, they were just questioning it and be like, what is that? What's this? What's that? What's this? Why does it look like that? You know, yeah, it doesn't look like this guy's 11.5 inch, you know, Geissele handguard, you know, it had all the quote unquote Gucci equipment all over the thing. But again, I do have a Mark 18 up there, you know, upper that's pretty viable. But back on track here with these new generation shooters, they were just kind of like, why you got this? Why you got that? You know, whatever. What I wanted to kind of throw out there while I was observing them, it's social media definitely is playing a role, because all they could do is get on their phones and they're on Reddit. Okay, and they're trying to upload pictures to Reddit, Instagram. So as an example, you guys have to let me understand this. The guy with the 11.5 inch SBR wanted to take a picture of his AR on the ground in the gravel. He put it on the ground, and he took his shoes off, and he took his socks off, and then he's trying to get the picture of his AR with his feet in the picture. What is that about? That was weird. And his friend did the same thing with his AR. He like with his you know, shoes in the picture, his feet in the picture, whatever. That's got to be some kind of inside joke. Yes, no? Please let me know in the comments section below what that's about. Other things that they were doing was just constantly looking at their guns and talking about it to each other and asking me to kind of, don't you think it's cool? Don't you like it? Come on, what do you think? And I'm like, yeah, it's nice. That's it? You don't think it's like awesome? I'm like, yeah, it's fine. I mean, what do you want me to do? Like bow down to you? So again, they're looking for some kind of validation of their for their gun. It's very, very interesting. The other thing was the friend was recording on his phone, the guy with the 11.5 inch SBR, shooting very rapidly. Okay, very rapidly. And I'm not sure what was going on, but he would put the AR on safe after he did a very fast string of fire, and he would ask it, did you get it? And he's like, oh, I didn't get you putting it on safe. He's like, no, let's try it again. You know, shooting real rapidly, putting it on safe. Did you get it? Well, I don't know. Here, look at it. Oh, that doesn't look good. That's the wrong angle. Go this way. I'm like, what? So it's almost like acting. So they did that for a little bit, but then they went back to just going on their phones. I don't know what they're looking at. I mean, I know one of them was trying to upload a picture and it wasn't working or something, and he was getting all pissed. So that's a new generation type of deal. These shooters are in their 20s, so they grew up with social media, right? And they grew up with that culture of whatever social media does. You know, when I was growing up, the early 2000s, okay, they had gun forums on the internet, but that was it. We weren't really doing videos or pictures, no way. We were exchanging information and things like that. And I've talked about this in another video, but I wanted to, again, just do this video on new generation shooters, because it's something that I see more and more often at the range. It's kind of interesting in a way, but man, I can't help but think it's all about flash and glam and, wearing a flannel shirt. Okay, what's up with flannel? These two guys are wearing flannel shirts, and it's kind of hot out. I don't know. And they were name dropping YouTube gun channels, and I wrote like two of them down, and they were pretty big channels. And I can see why they kind of act the way they do, because I don't know, they're trying to emulate these people in these channels. It's very interesting how powerful social media is. It could be dangerous and it could be helpful. You know, it goes both ways, I guess. But what do you think about all this? What do you see at your range? I think I've asked people this before, and I think people are seeing kind of the same thing. You know, the acting, this new attitude, like everybody's like a, you know, sarcastic, got to think of witty responses and titles. It's like, what is going on? So that's about it. I don't want to drag out this video much longer, but do tell me if you understand what the feet thing is, because I would like to know. It's kind of a thing I'm just wondering about, that I'm lost. Other than that, July might be spotty with me uploading videos, but I will do my best. So please stick with me, because I still want to continue to do these videos from time to time, or as much as I can. So just stick with me. Might be spotty coming up in the next few weeks. I might not put up a video. All right, guys, leave some comments below. Let me know what you think. And as always, stay safe and check 360 often. Later.